So we are now looking at our behavior reports. Behavior reports help tell us where users are engaging. It allows us to look at what pages are attracting and holding our user interest. So we're starting out, as we always do, in our overview section. And just like before, we have our graph, and we can change that. We can change our date range. But I want to point out another little trick here. So as you're learning analytics, sometimes these, what's the difference between page views and unique page views? So a little trick, when you hover over that word, it gives you a little tip telling you what they are. So now we know page views is the total number of pages. So if I have went into the Google merchandise store and I viewed four pages and I viewed the same page three times, that counts as four page views. Over here on unique pages, it doesn't include pages that I viewed twice. So if I viewed the same page three times in a session, that only counts as one view. So using that little hover is a great way to kind of get to know these different terms. And in some cases, you can even bounce down and learn more. Next thing I'll point out is behavior flow. And there's a lot of advanced things you can get into with behavior flow. And you can even set up different groupings in your behavior flow. But really what I want you to think about is this is how users are navigating through your site. So where they arrive in, most of them are arriving here on this home page. And then where do they go next? And so you can kind of see how they flow through your website. Why is this helpful? Well, if you have a lot of drops, is there a bad link? Is there something else going on? That can help you decide where you might need to make some changes. Similarly, if you end up with a lot of hits and they generate a lot of revenue, lets you know that that technique really worked. We're going to dive into site content a little more in depth, so I'll skip that right now and go to a couple of other ones. So site speed lets you know the speed of your pages. Interesting to browse. If you have multiple countries, you might want to sort this by different page timings and across demographics. That can really help, but let you know if there's any site that is a little slow to load. Site search lets you know what people are searching for on your page, so that can also be worth exploring. Let's pop back up here and dig into site content. So in looking at site content, we're viewing all of our pages. So this gives us a listing of all of our pages, and we can start digging into some of our pages and how they're performing. So one of the things we haven't talked a lot about is bounce rate. And so this is the percent of single page sessions, and there's no interaction. So that means I go to a page, I bounce right out. I don't do anything. And often a high bounce rate can indicate that there might be a problem with the page. It could also mean that the users are just not interested in our content, but it gives us an indicator. So it might be interesting to kind of sort our pages on our bounce rate. So one way to do that, and we've briefly looked at some of these more advanced tabs, but this is the comparison tab. And so now, and I can change whatever I'm looking at. So I'm going to compare page views to our bounce rate. And it gives us an interesting look at performance. So what pages have the lowest bounce rate? Which ones have the highest bounce rate? And we can make changes based on that. So that's always kind of an interesting way to look at our information. Let's go back to our full data, and we'll look at another metric. That's our page value. And so our page value is, and you can read that formula there, but it lets us know how many pages people have gone through, and then what the value of that overall page is. So we can sort through and now see which pages have the highest value. So a lot of different things that you can view under this site content.